Hey my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. I apologize for the long delay. I had children and their school starting. I needed to take a small break to fix my schedule so I can start filming again. So I'm back. Hopefully my kids don't come in the middle again. But do remember to like and subscribe. This case is a little gruesome, so if you are a little squeamish, do not watch or listen to this video. But if you're listening, do leave a comment, subscribe, and like, or even if you want me to do certain cases, just leave me a comment about a case that you want me to research about. This crime case dates way back in time, and it is among the most famous murder cases in Hong Kong, which includes the Hello Kitty murder, which I did do before. I'll leave a link on the screen somewhere so you can check it out and know what happened in that case. And the next murder case is called the Milkshake Murders. Maybe I'll do it next, but I haven't researched anything about this case, so I do not know what happened in this case. This crime case is called the Jars Killer, and it happened way before the Hello Kitty murder happened, which is why this murder case holds the title of being the first serial killer in Hong Kong. There might be more way before because this case is in 1880s. I feel like there might be more murder cases in Hong Kong, but I feel like this is the first one they really documented. And this case begins with Lam Kor Wan. I apologize, I can never pronounce names right, but he is the serial killer in this murder case. When Lam was really young, basically a kid, he was living with his parents in Malaysia. His childhood was very lonely. His father was very abusive towards him and his mother. Like, his father was so abusive to the point, I'll give you an example of his story. I've read one online. It says that his father hit him so hard that Lam lost his conscience. He basically fainted when his father hit him. And you can tell how abusive his father must have been to hit him, with no feelings at all. Being a father or a parent, I am a parent of three kids, and I think twice before saying anything or hitting my kids, so I can imagine how heartless his father must have been. When Lam was in his teens, his family decided that they were going to move to Hong Kong. And still at this point, Lam was lonely. He was having troubles connecting with people, making friends. I understand this issue because a normal person, myself, or any other person, would have difficulty finding friends as well. So, being someone who comes from a lonely past and an abusive father would have double as trouble finding people and connecting with people. That I understand. When Lam was an adult, he got a job as a taxi driver in Hong Kong, and he was working the night shift, which I also understand because in the morning people are more talkative and at night people are tired, or he was just a lonely person and just, nights are just quiet and that's what a lonely person and even I would prefer if I wasn't scared working at night. Even in his adulthood, Lam still lived with his family in Hong Kong, and he was sharing his bedroom with his younger brother. But Lam never had a girlfriend ever in his life, and this led him to secretly start hoarding pornographic magazines. And he would order them from Britain because he was embarrassed to buy them from over the counters anywhere. I don't know where you get these magazines in Hong Kong, okay? He was embarrassed to just get them from the counters. He kept these magazines locked and hidden away under his bed, and he never wanted his family to find out about these magazines. There came a time when Lam was no more interested in these magazines, so he bought a Polaroid camera and he started taking pictures of women in public toilet from under their toilets, and it just started going downhill from this point. This stopped soon because Lam almost got caught while a woman saw him taking pictures of girls and ladies from under their toilet, and she ran after him on the street, which frightened Lam, so he stopped taking pictures of, women in the public toilet. Being in such environment, you can tell Lam was not a happy person. Lam began his killing journey on the 3rd Feb 1982 when he picked up a woman passenger in his taxi outside a restaurant in Chim Sa Choi. Taxi drivers can be cuckoo, I tell you. I was 9 months pregnant and I just came from my hospital appointment. I had my sister with me and we were going back home. And we, you know, people in Hong Kong can be racist. So this taxi driver was a racist shit, I tell you. And we were close by where we wanted to stop and we told him, sir, please stop here. And he did not listen. He kept driving and luckily we stopped on a red light and we just ran out of the taxi. We did not pay. And that taxi driver crossed that red light, came after us, and I was 9 months pregnant. He was gonna hit me. And that was just crazy. So the first victim, I'll call her victim X because I suck at pronouncing names. She worked at a nightclub and the night that she got into that taxi, she was out with her sister and her friends. They were drinking, having snacks when she decided that she was gonna go home and then she took the taxi. So by now you know victim X was drunk when she got on that taxi. In the middle of her journey, victim X started to feel sick, so she asked Lam to stop the taxi. And when he pulled over, victim X opened the door and she puked outside. Afterwards, she wanted him to take her back to the same location that she got on this taxi, which Lam then was going to that location. And again, in the middle of the journey, victim X, you know, being drunk, so she was not in the state of making the decision, the right decision that she wanted to make. So she decided that she wanted to go back to the location she wanted to go in the first place. So when she told that to Lam, Lam snapped and he stopped his car, he got out of the car and he strangled her with an electrical wire. Over the next 7 months, Lam killed and dismembered three other women and he even took photos of her, of their body parts. When Lam was arrested for this murder, the police suspected that Lam wanted to be arrested and you'll know why when I start reading the next part. The reason why police believed that Lam wanted to be arrested because he took the riskiest and the most stupid step that any murderer or serial killer will ever take because he was bound to be arrested when he took this step. Lam was developing these pictures that he took of these bodies at a photography shop. So Lam did this not once but twice. That is why the police feel that he did this because he wanted to be arrested. So the first time he got caught by the Photoshop tech was when he asked him questions about the pictures of these body parts and he had a very narrow escape at this point. He was like, I have these pictures because I am a lab technician and these photos are for medical research. So the Photoshop tech was like, oh, makes sense. August 17, 1983 was when Lam got arrested because the Photoshop tech did a double take when he saw the pictures that Lam was developing now. There were pictures of the whole body, close-ups, and they were staged like in pornographic ways. Some pictures stood out more because it showed a burn mark on a woman's thigh and a severed breast, which is obviously quite scary if you're developing someone else's pictures that looks like murder. So the photo tech called the police and the next day when Lam was the time when Lam had to collect the pictures, the police were waiting outside the shop. When Lam pulled over in his taxi, police questioned him about these pictures and he mentioned that he was taking or collecting these pictures for his friend. Police being suspicious, they accompanied him to his house and when they arrived at Lam's house, his whole family was having dinner at the dinner table. House was pretty small and it did not take the police to find the evidence that they needed to connect the pictures with Lam. The police found a locked metal box under Lam's bed, which they asked him to unlock, and when he did unlock it, they found two Tupperware boxes sealed with masking tape. One of the detectives opened up one of the boxes that they found with the masking tape on, and inside was a severed breast. This case was so gruesome that there was a lady chemist working on it named Shyla Hamilton, and she was taken off this case because they considered this evidence to be too horrific for a woman to work with. And the second box that was taped with the masking tape contained a lady part as well. It was a vagina of the one of the women that was murdered. So both of these women parts were in a formaldehyde solution inside dead boxes. So because of these jars that the police found with the body parts, this whole case was called the Jar Killer case. A number of body parts and pornographic material made the police suspect that the whole family was in on it because it can't be a one-person job. So they arrested the whole family in suspicion with this murder. They were all taken to the police station and they were all assigned in different cells. So the next morning, when Lam was taken to meet his younger brother lashed out at him because the whole family didn't do anything, it was just Lam. So he was fighting, kicking him, shouting. So Lam promised to confess and reveal all the details of the murders he did. As promised, he revealed every single detail of the murders he committed. So, warning is going to get graphic with all itty-bitty details, but if you guys do not want to listen, just skip ahead and just listen to the end of what happened and what sentence he got. After strangling victim X, which was his first victim, he took her to his house at 5 a.m. when he usually finishes his, shift of driving the taxi around Hong Kong. So at that time, the streets are deserted, there's no one there. So he carried victim X's body up to his house. He hid her body under the sofa until everybody left for work and he was alone with her body. So when nobody was at home, Lam covered his bedroom with plastic and he put the body on top of it. Used an electric saw to cut up the body into pieces. He took photographs while he was working on that body. When he was done dismembering the body of victim X, he wrapped the head, limbs, and torso separately, and he placed these body parts in the boot of his car, his taxi, and he dumped them at night in the Sha Tin River. A week later, news reports started coming in of the body parts washing up in the Sha Tin River, but the police could not identify who did it at that point. The next murder was very well planned. He had surgical instruments, he had the formaldehyde solution that he put the body parts in. So I'll call the second victim, Victim Y. Victim Y was also a bar worker, and when he killed Victim Y, he also had sexual relations with her body before dismembering her. Lam later told the police that he had no interest in women sexually. He was just embarrassed about necrophilia. Necrophilia just means strange people's interest in dead bodies in a sexual way, which is gross. He said that he did not feel any remorse for the two victims he killed first or the third one, but there was also a fourth victim that I'll get on to. There was even a bar worker who said that these women who got murdered were useless to society. So whoever you are pathetic. I just had to say that. Lam had four victims that he killed in his killing spree. So the fourth victim was the only one that was different for him because she was a student. She was 17 years old at the time when she got murdered by Lam. She was having her sixth form dinner, which I feel like is a graduation dinner in Hong Kong that usually every school has. So she was out with her friends having a graduation dinner. This saddens me so much. When she decided that she was gonna cut it half and go home by taking a taxi. Her friends helped her get a cab so she can safely make home, but little did they know that she will not safely go home. Lam handcuffed victim Z at 9 p.m., which was way early than his normally killing time. He kept her strangled till 4 a.m. in the morning, talking about his life, his religion, his family, until victim Z fell. After victim Z fell asleep, he strangled her the same way, took her body home. So the fourth victim is the one which led to Lam's arresting, because the picture of the burnt thigh was of the fourth victim, and it happened when Lam was setting up the location where he was going to dismember the fourth victim with the lights, and one of the lights fell on the body and burnt the leg. He was found guilty for all four counts of murder, and he is still going on with his life sentence in prison. I'm not sure if he's dead or not. I do not want to search. But I do not know what to think about this case. Part of me feels sad about such peoples who go through, you know, abusive backgrounds and just turn up ugly. It's just not their fault. They're like, base of their life is not properly fixed. It's just because of that, they cannot fix the top part of their life as well. So part of me thinks that he made himself get arrested, and part of me thinks that it was just a stupid mistake, a risky step he took, which led him to be arrested. I don't know. What do you guys think? Do let me know. And if you want me to do more cases like this, do let me watch TV series. So the only closest way I can feel like a police or a crime scene investigator is by searching up such historic cases. The two reasons why I post these videos is, one, because I want you guys to pray for the beautiful lost souls so their heaven is beautiful up there, and the second is because I wanted to be a crime scene investigator, so this is the closest I can get to it. Okay, bye.